Hello and welcome, crafters. It's Heather at the Craft Shack, and you're going to notice a few changes in today's broadcast. Number one, it's not Tuesday. And for those of you watching live, that is kind of different. We usually do it on Tuesdays in the summertime. However, yesterday we had a whole lot of difficulties, so I'm making it up by doing a show on Wednesday. We will be back to Tuesday as of next week. Now, what else is different? You may notice a little sign there in the center of your coffee cup. I know it doesn't look too good, but I'm working on that part of it. Anyway, that's called an overlay, thanks to some really awesome, there it's gone, there it's back. Anyway, I had some major training yesterday on how to use YouTube and how to use Google Plus Hangouts, and I'm just all excited about the stuff that I've learned. So, as a matter of fact, I'm so excited, I even have sounds. Yay! I know, like, anybody cares. But anyway, okay, so let me get back to this and turn that off, switch this over, and hi, it's me! And look at this, watch. Looky there. So now you know that it's me, Heather, at the Craft Shack. So I am having a lot of fun. I spent a couple hours with a guru of Hangouts, and he taught me a whole lot of things, got me situated with some stuff, and that brings me to the next thing I wanted to share with you, is that we do have a Google page now for Craft Shack, and it's so very sad because I have one singular person on there. So what I need is for you to go to Craft Shack, the page, and I'm going to try to put it in the description after the video is posted to YouTube. But I also have it so that you can go to my website, craftshack.com, and if you click where it says live up at the top, it'll take you directly to this show when it's live. Pretty cool, right? I'm excited. So hopefully that's working. We've also got some other things. If you comment, I should be able to see it, and I should be able to see it in this window. So we're going to see how that works. I'm not exactly sure how that works, but we'll see. Let's see. I wonder if I zoom out just a little bit. There, now it doesn't look like the words are choking me in the face. And you can see all my little messes going on. Got a past project sitting there, all nice and pretty. I'm not sure where I'm going to put that yet. I think it's going to go in my bedroom, but I do want to share it with my grandma. It's her birthday in November, and we're going to go visit her. So, anyway, so I'm waiting for, I'm not waiting for anything. I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing exactly. It's been a crazy couple of days as far as the computer is concerned, and of course it's summertime, so we're really busy around here when it comes to summer, because we have it for like two whole days out of the year, a little longer than that. But anyway, it just seems like we try to get everything done in the summertime, and so we're just constantly trying to work on, you know, things outside, things around the house, things you just can't do in the wintertime. So, yeah, and it's not always, it just doesn't seem like it's always that easy to do the things that need to be done when it's so nice outside. And you know, it has been warm. It has been a lot warmer than we're used to, but usually it doesn't get this warm until the end of August, middle to the end of August. So it's kind of weird that we're getting the heat spell so soon. But it did cool off a little bit, and the night times are very cool, almost cold. So we're doing all right. So anyway, enough of the weather. I was looking on Facebook to see if anybody had any problems getting to the show. If you are here, I'm trying to figure out, let's see. Yeah, I'm not really sure how the comment thing works. So if somebody could post a comment, I'm showing that there are viewers. So if somebody could post a comment and let me know what yeah, I don't know. Let's see. Oh, I know another way that I could look and see. Hold on one second. I'm just trying to, you know, here's how it goes when we do new stuff, right? Just always trying to figure it out. And I'm trying to do the best presentation for you guys, and it is a, you know, free show, so you do kind of have to be my guinea pigs just a little bit. But anyway, 1 second, it's still loading. Hold on. It's loading! Do I make faces when I'm looking at it? I can't see myself, so I don't know if I'm making faces or what dealio is, but let's see. I go here, and does it look like we're on there? I don't know. It's running kind of slow. Okay, I think I've figured it out, but I don't know. I'm not sure where to leave messages, if there are any messages to be left. So let's just let it go, and I'll figure that part out. Don't worry about it. Hopefully, if you are on, I'll see your messages afterwards for sure. If you are watching live, please comment. Sorry if I can't see it right away, but I'll try. And if you are watching the recorded version, please leave a message too, letting us know that you watched it recorded, and that'd be great. So I think that's it for, wait 1 minute. We have a giveaway that we are doing at the end of every month this summer. So on the final Tuesday of July, the beginning of that broadcast, I will be giving away, let me grab the prize package. I will be giving away where'd the prize package go? Oh, I'm ridiculous. Okay, here we go. I will be giving away the July prize package. Dun, 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 dun. Now, how do you enter to win? Well, first, let's look at the prize package, and then I will let you know how you can enter to win this Tim Holtz Distress Ink. This is a re-inker, peeled paint, so you've got a lot of uses in this, and a great big acrylic block. This is a 2 by 6.5 inch block. We've got some fun little acrylic pillows. They're those pillow boxes. They're clear. They're lots of fun to fill with goodies and awesome to decorate. And then 2 mini albums that I had in my stash, and I thought, you know what, somebody's going to be able to put these to really good use. So this is this July's prize package, and you enter by leaving a comment on any of the videos that I do this month. So if you have not commented before, I believe you do have to be a YouTube subscriber or YouTube member. I don't know if that's the right word. Anyway, in order to leave a comment. So that much I'm pretty sure about. But anyway, and then of course you'll want to watch the last Tuesday of the month to find out if you were chosen to win, because if you don't claim your prize, then I'm going to have to give it to someone else. So anyway, let's move on to crafting. What do you guys think? Time to craft. Yeah, I think so. All right. Okay, so let me move the camera. And yeah, I'm not sure if, I wonder, hold on 1 second, let me see if this will give me, yeah, I don't know. If there's anybody out there watching and you leave a comment on the YouTube channel, hopefully it'll show up here, but if somebody could just try it for me, that would be awesome. All right, let me check the camera settings and see if we have the right view. That looks pretty good. All right, that looks pretty good. What do you say? Dum, 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 dum. I got a message from somebody. Let's see. Oh, Evelyn. Okay, Evelyn, you are watching, but you cannot comment. Well, that stinks. All right, well, I appreciate you commenting on Facebook and letting me know. Thanks, Evelyn. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We'll just forget about that stuff and, yeah, I say let's forget about it, and then I sit here and play with it anyway. Okay, so what I'm going to do is show you something totally unique, at least unique to me anyway. I have been wanting this stamp set for quite some time, trying not to get a glare on there. And it's something that I have needed, actually, because I've done a lot of wedding cards and just kind of made do. And so this is going to be lots of fun. And it is coordinated with the Cricut Artiste cartridge that Close to My Heart sells. And what I want to tell you about this is if you are going to use this, it tells you what page, which is page 51 of the book, and it tells you to do it at 1.5 inches, but this is the image you're using, and these two images are interlinked or linked. Now, if I were to cut this out at 1.5, it will scale this heart down. I believe this is correct. It will scale this heart down to fit within that. Now, if I want to do the 1.5 inches, I need to make sure I use the button on my keypad. Let me show you where that is. That says real dial size. So you want to push real dial size, then shift because it's over in the right box. And then you want to use accent 2 and then the letter A. And that's how you get this cut out. Now I cut out 4 of those already, and it looks like I have a message, so I'm going to check that and see. And well, that just stinks. So I'm sorry, Jerry Ann, I'm glad you're here. That part is good. Not that, you know, you being here stinks, but it stinks that it's not letting you guys comment. So I will figure that out before next week's show. And I am so grateful to you guys letting me know that, because it does help me to know that somebody's out there listening, watching, and everything else. But sorry, major bummer, that it isn't letting you guys comment. Which is, whoops. I clicked a button. Oh, okay, there we go.
And
I clicked a button, and it took me to some weird land where I hear my voice. Okay. All right, so if you're on Facebook, you can comment on Facebook. Jerry Ann messaged me, and of course you can comment on the Craftbook fan page if you're there. And I'm very sorry, guys, that you're not able to comment, but we'll figure it out before next week. With everything new, it seems like I find 4 different things to be wrong. So anyway, let's move on. All right, so I'm going to use, I already cut out 4 of these hearts because I don't know if I'm going to use them all or not, but I just wanted to have them. And I used the Artiste cartridge for that. So that's done. And we'll be using the stamp set. And, okay, so for today's card, these are the these are the supplies that I used. I took two colonial white pieces of cardstock. One I used to cut out the hearts, and the other one I cut into 4s, 6x6. And I'm just taking this off the Cricut sheet, because this is what we're actually going to use to stamp on and do our embellishments. So this one I'm going to save, set that aside, and we'll put our embellishments on that. And I'm just kind of tidying up as I go, because I'm going to need the space. For the next, so I've cut the colonial white into 6x6 squares. There's 4 of them out of one paper. And I've got my Sizzix, let's see if you can read that. Probably not. It's the Sizzix Album Accordion Flip 3D, and it's by Karen Berniston. And what I like to do, I got 2 B plates for my Cuddlebug. You can use any machine. And this just lays right on top. And the B plate right on top of that. I like to use mine upside down because, well, the B plates bend, and after a while they kind of get a warp. And I kind of like to fight against that warp sometimes. So, anyway, this gonna get might get a little shaky. Apologies. Anyway, just put the sandwich in, and it's going to pop and crack and wiggle. My camera is kind of attached to my desk, so it does move when I do stuff. So this is what that looks like when it comes out. Get rid of the extra pieces here. Okay, and I cut four of these. I've already done three, so now we have a total of four. And we'll show you, I'll show you how those go together in a bit. Then I took two sheets of the designer paper from the For Always pack, and I just took two of the same sheets out of the paper pack, and I cut it into four squares, the 6x6 squares again, and then using a different die. This one is also from Karen Bernstein, and it's called the Frame and Label Bracket. And this coordinates with the one we just used. And I'm trying to position this so that it definitely is in the center because I can reuse this frame. And I'll show you what I mean. All right, so put that sandwich in. And this one's really going to crack and pop because I actually have two squares of designer paper on there. So 1 second and I'll get to that message. Here we go. Sorry, Wiggly. Sorry. All right. Now, what I get out of this, let me check the message and see what was said. Is Ruby. Okay, let's see. I can zoom out of this too so it's not so in your face. Well, I thought I could anyway. That's it. Okay, so what I'm left with, let me put the cuddlebug away because we're done with that, is this large frame, which I can reuse this for any project, and it's double-sided, so we've got two in one basically. And I can use that on a scrapbook page or another card. And then what we're going to use today are, there's three pieces that come out of that. Okay? We're actually going to use this larger piece and this inside piece. And not going to use this today. So there are some extras that you can utilize for other projects. I'm really excited about that part. Now what I did do is cut out the other six sheets, and those are right here that I had already cut out ahead of time, and I'm just going to move my dies out of the way, move my B plates out of the way. All right, and we're left with all of these large square frames and these smaller frames go away, and these inside label dies, they go. Now these are double-sided, so we're going to get a lot of use out of these. This is going to be fun. All right, and this is just scrap. I'm sure you could use it for something else, but it has this angle cut here, so I don't have a use for it. I'm going to toss that. But generally speaking, you use almost the entire 12x12 sheet of paper to do this. So it's one piece of cardstock and two pieces of designer paper, preferably something that's double-sided because you can get more out of it that way, but it doesn't have to be. And then I used another 12x12 cardstock to cut out these, and I'll use the rest for stamping. Okay? So I'm going to set these aside for just a moment, and we're going to stamp. And let me get out my stamp pad. Protects my desk, and it's got the foam underneath so I get real good stamped images, which is important. And I tried to get everything here within fingertips, and I forgot the embossing powder that I want to use. Typical me. Okay, so I'm just going to stamp. I love this stamp set. And I'm sorry for the glare. There's just no way around that at the moment. Now that doesn't help. Okay, so I'm going to stamp several of these images, the words. I like this, wishing you a lifetime of happiness. We're definitely going to use that one. And I like bride and groom also. I think we will use that one as well. I'm just putting them on my blocks, getting them ready. And I like the bell. And the cake I like too, but I'm not sure if I want to use that on this card because of how small the inside label is. So I think we're going to use the smaller stamps, which, let's see, I've got I need a smaller, I'm missing a block. Well, we'll just use this for now. I'm just going to cut these out so it doesn't really matter. So I've got the man and wife, or the man, whatever, and the bow. And I also want to use the heart. And I'm just going to use the back side of this for the heart. And I think that's going to go on a different color. So let me check message, see what we got. All right, that was from something else. Okay, so like the world has woken up and it's decided to start messaging me. Okay, so I've got my VersaMark ink, but what I don't have is the colored ink that I want to use for the heart. And okay, I know what I'm doing. Okay, so I've got my tray with my embossing powder, and yeah, I'm using embossing powder that's no longer available. Sorry about that. I'm sure you've got stuff in your stash that nobody else can buy. Might as well use it. I've got my VersaFine Onyx Black ink, which I cannot say enough about this. I absolutely love this stuff. Very grateful that somebody told me. I think it was Eniku who told me that I needed to get it, and I am very grateful. And then I've also got Cranberry ink, which I think that's what I'm going to use to do the heart. So let's just stamp and see what we do. I think I'm going to do one black bride and groom. Now, I've told you this before. If I get new stamps, I usually either do one of two things. I either rub it on my skin to get that film off, or I do a stamp off. Ink it all up and then stamp off to get any of those imperfections off of that, and now it's seasoned and ready to be used. And let's just do that with all of them so we get that out of the way. So these are just, it's just a scratch piece paper that I'm doing these messy stamps on. I like to really cram it into the ink pad. It seems like a waste, doesn't it? But I like to make sure my ink is really seasoned, or my stamps, I'm sorry, my stamps are really seasoned before I get started. And I try to do this kind of thing off camera sometimes, but it doesn't always work. Okay, so now I'm just going to put this one down. Look at how sharp that image is. I love that. That's great. And I think I'm going to do that with, I want the bride and groom, I think, to be black also, like, because they're silhouettes. And we'll just get a bonus bow as well. Now, when you're doing solid stamps, you want to make sure, I've told you this before, but I want to make sure you know, You want to twist, 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 pounce, pounce, pounce. That's going to give the best coverage of ink on that solid stamp. So that way you don't have any of those hidden little splotchinesses. Let's do the bell also, just so we have it, and we'll also do this one, because I'm really not sure what's going to look the best. Okay, so we've got those great sharp images in black, and that looks pretty good. Now I want to do the same thing with the VersaMark. And here's how I clean my stamps, too. I like to just stamp off until it's done. Except VersaMark, or VersaFine is different, so somebody, I know if I could get comments right now, I'd be hearing, no, you want to wipe that off. So I'll comment for you. No, Heather, you want to wipe that off. I just got a baby wipe here, and I'm just going to do that. Yeah, there, that looks clean. Same with this one. And this one. I don't like cleaning my stamps on air. I really don't. It's such a waste of our time together. But I guess it's a necessary part of the job. Okay. Give myself a little bit more room here. Okay. Now with my VersaMark ink, I am going to do the same thing, but first I'm going to use my embossing buddy. My embossing buddy tutorial has gotten a little bit of traction lately. If you haven't seen that, it's on my YouTube page, and where I made this. All right, so now I've got that all clean and static free. I'm just going to go through and stamp. First, I'm going to cut this off. This is going to make life easier. Let's just trim it down. Trim this down and make life a little bit easier. I make enough mistakes on this show that I don't need to do ones that are so silly. All right. I'm just going to give ourselves a little bit less paper to work with. I think that'll make things a little easier. And I recently was asked how I like my trimmer. It just takes getting used to. I think they all do that. You know, take time getting used to them. It's not my favorite, but it's okay. You love the VersaFine ink too, Jerrianne. It does dry quick and usually never smear. I know, the Close to My Heart Black does smear, and it dries out pretty fast. I don't mean dries fast, I mean dries out, like the ink pad itself dries out fast. So, I didn't fully clean that one, darn it. That's alright, it doesn't really matter. So, you'll be able to see this on camera anyway. There, now you can see the image because, I didn't fully clean it off. Which actually might help me figure out where to put all this stuff. All right, I'm just going to do the bow for this one. I don't really want the whole kit and caboodle. And the bride and groom. Okay. All right, put that away. All right, so now what I'm going to use is the Silver Pearl. This is quite old. I mean, I don't know how many catalogs ago you could buy this, but there's other stuff on the market out there. Very similar, if not, you know, maybe even something a little different. Maybe you don't want to use Silver Pearl, so not a big deal. All right, and I'm just going to go ahead There's some weird mark. No. 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 There isn't. I was seeing something. Okay. What's really cool is you guys can see, because I made that mistake, you can see what I'm doing. So that's kind of nice. I'll check that comment in just a minute. All right, and so then as it starts to turn, start moving. I got to tell you guys, I've really enjoyed doing these live shows for the simple fact that it gets me crafting, but also because I have gotten to know some of you off camera, and I feel like I'm really blessed by these friendships that are created, all because we, you know, reached out and touched someone, basically, on the internet, so it's kind of cool. Okay, so what you can't really see is that it is white, pearly white. It's kind of a silver, so it's there. Anyway, let's see, what messages am I getting? You have some in your stash too, Jerrianne, that's awesome. I know, some of those products are the ones that you wish were there all the time, right? Oh, that's funny. Okay, so Ruby and Carly are watching. How awesome is that? When was the last time we had Ruby and Carly on, you guys? I don't know that I can say ever. Oh, look at there. I can see comments. Eniku and Evelyn. And there's Ruby and Allie Cooter. Hey, I don't know you, Allie, so I'm glad that you joined us. Yay. And let's see. Carly says, hi, Grandma. She woke up mommy so that you can watch. Well, that's wonderful. Thank you, Carly. Look at this. I want to show you guys something. Watch this. Let's see. That would be Ruby. She's in love with Pirates of the Caribbean, or at least that was her thing there. So, hi, Grandma, says Carly, who woke up mommy. Ha ha. How cool is that? And then look at this. Hello, Eniku. Yay, you made it. So happy. And Evelyn, yay, you got it to work. I'm so glad. Okay, so, hello, Allie, welcome, and yes, we love giveaways here. We do one every single month, I promise. So, and you can see the pearly shine. That's wonderful, Eniku. Thank you. All right, so that's pretty cool. That's a really neat thing that we just got on there. Anyway. Okay, so I will stay on Facebook, though, so Jerrianne, you don't have to worry. You can comment on Facebook still, and I won't be able to show it to the world, which I don't know how to get it off there now. There we go. I won't be able to show it to them, but I will definitely be able to answer your questions or even just make comments like you do. Okay, so you can see this. That's great. I'm just going to quickly cut these out. I'm not going to do something super fancy. It's going to be quick. I just want the impression of these guys, these little doodads on my card. And we'll get to assembling that card. And you can see just how cool this is going to be using that die that we cut at the beginning. But how cool is that? I didn't realize that I could do that with the comments. And I learned yesterday with my guru, Mr. Hangout Guru. His name is Ronnie. If you are interested in doing any of this kind of stuff, he will help, I promise. He's got some free videos and information and different shows that he does all the time showing you how to use different things. So if you're not interested in paying, you don't have to. But you know, if you want the in-depth version, like I got yesterday, I got 2 whole hours with him. We did an online hangout, just like we're doing right now, only he was with me and we were talking and able to screen share and do all kinds of stuff to walk me through how to set up a page for Craft Shack. Which again, if you are on Google Plus, please, please, please circle my page, Craft Shack, and let's get it some growth out there in the world, because I'm just such a tiny little entity now. It's all brand new. So it looks like I don't know anybody, even though I have so many of you that are watching and hanging out with me on Facebook and doing all kinds of stuff everywhere. And I've gotten so many subscribers that we may be close to 100, very close to 100. I think I was at 96 yesterday. I don't know where we're at now. I haven't checked it today, but when we get to that 100 subscriber mark, there's going to be a little bit of a party going on in my mind, and we can maybe do another giveaway. We're close to 100 videos, too. Can you believe that? It's like it's almost like they're neck and neck. But anyway. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing with these ones really quickly. I'm not sure if I want to use... I feel like I've got to cut these out anyway just because I don't know... I don't know what's going to look best until I do it, so... And I'm just really quickly cutting them, so it's not like this is as bad as paint drying, but close. Very close. Okay. We have eight panels to decorate, and one of the things that I did want to do was the stamping of the hearts, and I thought about possibly making some little rosettes, but I'm not sure if I'm going to get to that before the show is over. But you know, it's my show. I can do it however long I want, I guess. It's all up to you guys as to whether you watch the whole thing or not. Do you like these longer shows? I mean, those of you who have been watching for a while don't seem to complain about... I know I have a friend who watches the recorded versions, but she kind of skips through. And I am learning how to do chapters, so we might be able to have that feature in the future where you could skip from, you know, the talking in the beginning to the... just go straight to the craft or... where to see the assembly, or see where I screwed up on something, who knows. Wouldn't that be a nice little chapter? Hey, Heather, you messed up. Watch Heather break something. Watch Heather drop the camera again. Okay. Oh, is that Jerry Ann? Am I using the close to my heart scissors? Yes, and I love these. These are the Teflon coated ones. I love these. Yes, Jerry Ann, they are awesome. They are from Close to My Heart, and you can get them from any Close to My Heart salesperson. Jerry Ann does, she's an independent consultant for Close to My Heart. So am I. Very cool. I'm trying to get Ruby on. If anything, just so I could at least have her kit. Just kidding. Just kidding, sort of. I'm kidding, but not 100% kidding. All right. Just about finished with these. That didn't take too long, did it? I love fussy cutting with these. They're just like the best for that. Okay, so I have a black version of everything and a pearly version of all but the bride and groom. And then here are my hearts. So now let's do, make sure I got all the black off this one because I am going to do that red. All right, and I am going to test this one first because this is one of those solid stamps. And so I want to make sure that I don't have anything on it that's going to mess up the stamped image. Which already I see a piece of glitter. How'd that happen? If you're in the craft shack and you're like allergic to glitter, you do not want to be here because this place, glitter finds you. I just don't quite understand it all, but. I like it, but it's not, it's like my color isn't. saturated enough or something. Yeah. Let's see. Talking at the beginning is Aniku's favorite part. And Allie, yes, I watch both. This is my first live show, and I love it. Oh, I'm so glad you're here. And Criden, I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. Criden? Let me show you guys. Her first time, and you're enjoying it. I'm so glad that you're here. And Allie's first time at a live show. Awesome. And Evelyn says, I plan to look for a pearly embossing powder when I go to the craft store. You know what? Good luck, because I did find one. I don't remember when it was. I did find one, but I asked somebody at the sales lady, and she's, oh, we don't have anything like that. And I did find one, but it wasn't the same as this. Let's see, what does my dear friend say here? Try Ruby. Oh, yes, I know. I agree. Jerry-Ann, Ruby is telling you, Ruby, Jerry-Ann is telling you that you need to try. You need to try Close to My Heart. She's right, you do. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and try and stamp these. And Aniku, it's so sweet of you to say that the talking at the beginning is your favorite part. Sometimes I tell some really good, juicy stories. Do you know that some of those just, like, come to me the night before and I can't sleep because I'm thinking about what I'm going to talk to you guys about? And it really isn't something that that I try to plan. It just sort of happens. So when that does, it can be good. All right, that turned out pretty good. I'm glad that I played around with it first, because I think I got the ink pad juicy messing around with it. All right, and my only issue now, you may notice, is that the glare from the light above my table is causing me to be unable to see the stamp. So I have to put my hand up to block the glare. So, yeah. Let's see, what does Jerry-Ann have to say now? Try Ruby ink. Oh, wait a minute. Listen to this. That was funny. That's why I did that. That was funny. Yes, you're right. Try Ruby ink. Except I don't have it. I wish I did, but I don't have it. So I do know someplace where I can get it, though. All right, I'm not sure if I'm going to use all of these. I'm just going to do those three. And just leave it like that. Okay, so there we go. There are all of my embellishments. I've also got this zip strip from one of the 12x12 papers that we're going to utilize that as well. Put my stamps over here so they're out of our way. And we'll remove the embossing powder also. So I'm not sure what I did with that tray, so that's going to come back and bite me. I can already tell. Okay. Now, for the assembly, let's set these aside and let them be what they're going to be. And I've also got some bling and some roses, little roses that I use to add as well. Okay, for the first step, you'll want to take one of these frames, label frames, and trim off these tabs, these little tabs right here. Okay, and then this long tab. And I don't know if you guys can see this, probably not on screen, but there is a folding guide right there. So I'm just following that scored line that the die already put in for us, and trimming that off, which I'm obviously doing a very good job of that. There we go. Okay, so that's one done that way, and then all the rest are just as is. Okay. and try to do this on camera. It's not going to go great. So this is the one that's been trimmed. We're going to sit that all the way to the right. And let me get my score tape. Now this is actually scrappy tape. I'm still using the scrappy tape. I have so much, the scrappy tape has worked so well for me that I haven't needed to buy more score tape. So the first thing is to put this is quarter inch, I believe. And I am just going to tear a piece off and put this on. This one label here. Okay, so that's going to go on that edge. And I can actually do two of these. So I really want to get a good adhesion. And before I do anything else, I'm going to wipe my hands off with a baby wipe because I am getting red ink on things. So I must have put my pinky in the ink pad or something. Shocking, I know. All right, let's see. We've got some more comments. So, Critton, I think you're saying yes to me saying your name correctly. I hope that's correct. Yes, you said my nickname right. Good. Yay. And Evelyn says, once glitter is in a room, there is no getting it out, ever. And, oh, Aniko, you're so sweet. I like seeing your cute face, and you make me laugh with your expressions. You know, I try. There's got to be something good about what I'm doing, I guess. And Ruby says she loves the sound effects. Yay! Wait. Loves the sound effects. I could tell a joke, but it won't be that good, so it's not worth it. All right, so let's get back to crafting. My hands are clean. All right, so I'm just going to put a little more of that tape on the little tab right here, and I am going to use my scissors for this because it's so little, and right there. Okay, so I put the tape on these two tabs, and I'm going to do that for all of these. And I could have done that ahead of time as well, but I wasn't thinking. So this is easier for me if I turn it, and I'm just following the scored guideline. And there is a little bit of overlap here, but it won't really matter all that much. I'm going to do this with the third one. And then, of course, the fourth one has been cut off, so we don't need to worry about that. Now, if you don't have a Cuddlebug or a Big Shot or a Tim Holtz Vagabond or whatever it is that they sell out there for all of these embossing, all of those manual die cutting machines, I'm sure there's another way that you could probably do something similar to this. I just happen to know that thing, when I first saw it, CHA videos, when I first saw this die, I thought, man, I've got to have that. And then, lucky for me, a friend of mine asked me to do a customized gift for her. And we needed this die for it, so I had to buy it. Darn. All right, so let's see. Okay, so the first step to assembling this is to just assemble it straight across. So we're going to remove the stick, remove the paper backing for the sticky, blah, 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 blah. I also need someone to be able to speak, because clearly I don't do that well. I think because I'm doing and thinking at the same time, it just doesn't work all that great. So now I'm just lining this edge up, this edge, with the scored piece here. Now notice I haven't pre-folded those yet. It's a little easier if you don't. I have put together two of these so far and learned some tricks along the way. So the first step, the instruction guide to this thing, I should show it to you. It is very lacking, very much. Oh, I was going to say, Evelyn, if you do find a pearly embossing powder, let us know, because I would love to be able to tell people where to find it. I started to tell you, I was looking at Michael's, and when I asked the girl at the counter, she thought I was nuts. Then I did find it, but it still wasn't what this stuff is, so. This is very crucial to this part. You need a bone folder, only because it will help you burnish the edges together, but I need to remove this pad before I do that. So we'll wait till it's all stuck together. Usually I use my poking tool because my nails are terrible, but by the time I think about it, I'm already done. So let's see, we're gonna just add this to this edge, like so. Okay, so now removing my protective sheet. Now I'm on my desk, which gives me a better surface to do this on. And I'm just going to adhere or burnish using my bone folder. Okay, so there we go. There's our four panel base of our card. Now, I am leaving the sticky on these little tabs. We're not going to mess with that yet. Now we're going to get these out. These are the large part of the frame, not the outside of the frame. This is the regular frame part. That was just the leftover, but I think it's usable. So, okay, and then we're going to adhere these over the top of what we just did. Now you have options because it's double-sided. You can do alternating, or you could do it all one way. So I don't know what we're going to do. I think I'm going to do it all one way on each side, just for the sake of my brain. But you could alternate them. You could do all kinds of stuff. Now I'm using Tombow Multi-Glue because it's fast. I hate waiting on screen for me to peel off those little tabs of paper. All right. Done with that one. See, that's way faster than if I were to use the scrappy tape or score tape. Score tape is, I believe, in my opinion, this is just my opinion, that scrappy tape and score tape are interchangeable. I'm sure the company does not feel that way. The makers of score tape are probably not happy about that, but whoops. That's just my opinion. I've tried them both, and I would prefer to save the money and just do scrappy tape over score tape. Even with the discount that I have received in the past for score tape, the scrappy tape beat that by far. Now that one's down, I wish I would have done it opposite. But you know what? If you've watched this show ever before, you know that I am always making happy little accidents. Let's just hope it works out that way this time as well. And this is the For Always paper pack that I'm using. I have gotten so many projects out of this. I actually made a wedding gift for our nephew and his new bride that are getting married next month out of this paper, which is why I'm making this card, because, well, I need to give them a card with that gift, right? And I thought, why don't I use the same paper? And of course, there's tons of paper when you buy a paper pack. You get so much. And if you buy the workshop on the go, you get the paper pack plus, and you save when you buy it that way. And you're just able to use so much. I'm using up the adhesives in my stash. I could not believe how much glues I had because I wanted to try it out. That is from Jerry Ann. And are you talking about, like, all these different adhesives? I have a ton of different adhesives. Let's see. And you always go back to your favorite. I know. I have several extra adhesives in my basket that I actually leave for the kids, because when the kids come over, I'm like, no, don't touch that. That's the good stuff. So, Evelyn may visit her scrapbook store this Saturday, and they might have it. Let us know, Evelyn. We want to know. If you could come back here and comment where you found it, that would be awesome. Okay, so the next thing is to flip it over and to do the same thing. I'm going to do the opposite picture or paper on the back side. And I do really wish I would have alternated. I think that would have been better. But this is okay. This is okay. It will work just fine. The other thing I've been trying to do, going back to learning how to use YouTube and Google Plus and all of this stuff, is making an event that lets you comment within the event, and it lets you comment on your way there, and you could say things like, what products are you using so that I can craft along with you, and I could give you a product list ahead of time. Just kind of cool stuff like that. But you could also comment and say, hey, just heard from Jerry Ann, you're doing a show, and so I thought I'd join it. Stuff like that. Or Jerry Ann could say, I also do a live scrapbooking show. If anybody would like to join me, I'm at this date and time, and here's the link. You could add stuff like that. The only issue is, I don't know how to do it yet. I started an event, and I think that is how Critten found us, which is great. But within the event, I was unable to start this video, so I'm really not sure what I'm doing wrong. But I will find out probably before the end of the month. Or at least before the end of the summer. I will definitely be able to start the new season. After school starts, we'll start a new season, and I'll be able to do that so much easier. But anyway, so there we go. This is, and now, with all of this on there, it's pretty thick. It's become a very sturdy item. And somewhere is my scoreboard. I love my Martha Stewart scoreboard. It didn't come with this red line down the middle. That's a trick I learned somewhere. I think her name was Heather Paper Castle or something. I think I saw her do this and I was like, brilliant! Okay. So now I'm just going to go through and score. These were already scored, but now that I put this paper on, it's not so prevalent. And I'm just going to go through and score these again. And you got to be careful because there's four layers of paper here. Well, three, I guess. Three layers. No, there's four because it's overlapping. So you got to be really careful how you do it. Okay, so now they should be able to fold. And I want to fold them like an accordion, hence the name accordion album. That's why it's called that. Yep. And this one. Okay, so the next step is to attach these little inside labels. Now, there are some folds that have been marked, but they're not pre-folded yet, so I do want to give those a little bit of a help, I guess. So Ruby says, speaking of craft stores, when are we going to Midtown? Midtown is the new craft store in our town, where we live, and I don't know. When are we going? We could go Thursday, which is tomorrow. We could go tomorrow. That works for me. Okay, so this is how it's supposed to go. Okay, and then just attach these. Now you want to attach them so that they are behind the fold. So however this is folded, I want this to attach here. I don't want it to attach over here. That won't work. It'll have to fold the other way. So behind the fold. I hope that makes sense. Attach behind the fold. Now it's okay. These little labels that, again, you're going to watch me peel off these little pieces of paper. But these little tabs are going to get covered with a piece of paper. So it'll look great when it's done. I promise. All right. Now, just going to attach the top one and then the bottom one and take a look at that. I think I did it a little too far, but that's fine. Okay, and now this one's going to go the opposite. So this one goes inside that way. This one's going to go inside this way. I did have to do a couple of trial runs of this thing just to see how to put it together, because like I said, those instructions were lame. So if you do decide to purchase the die, or if you have the die in your stash and have wondered how the heck do I use it, refer back to this video. Wouldn't it be nice if I had chapters so that you could just go, now where did, how did she put it together and not have to listen to all my banter? Oh well. Okay, so then the same thing with this one. I'm just trying to take those tabs off because you guys know I don't have nails. When I have tried to have nails, like, they weren't even fake. It just didn't work. So forget about it. I'd rather craft than have beautiful nails anyway. Some of you have beautiful nails and craft. For you, I say awesome sauce. I am not you, though. All right, Evelyn, I'm glad you're going to let us know, because I really would like to know where you can find it, because I have quite a bit of embossing powder, but it is my favorite one, and I would like to get more. So share with us your awesomeness. Okay. Now I'm just going to give these a bend so that they will freely go. Now watch what happens when it folds up. It actually does fold flat. Of course, you do have to kind of burnish it with a bone folder. All right, I think Jerianne sent us a message again, so let me check that out. Sorry, Jerianne, that I have to keep going over to see your messages, but I'm just grateful that we figured out how to communicate. All right, so this is what the base of it is, with the all put together like that. And, whoops, wrong one. I'm out of camera. Yeah, I know. What do you know? Let's see. Am I okay now? Are we better? Sorry that I was out of camera trying to put that together. It was a little messy. Just because I can't see way over here. This is about 2 feet in front of me, as long as my arms are, I guess. It's not quite 2 feet, but okay, so that's that part of it. Now we take these labels, and I'm going to do the opposite. So whatever you see here, now notice that I can't really, at this point, I can't lay it down and work on it. So I'm going to do the opposite. So this side is the flowers, so I'm going to put the glue on the flower side. And this will just fit nicely inside of that label, like so. Now I did notice that if I line up these points here to these points here, then I get a really good picture. All right, Allie, I'm glad that you added us to, here, let me check, hold on, let's see. Allie says, Now I see. I was wondering how that die was going to work out. Very snazzy. Just added you to my Google Plus circle. Thank you so much for adding me. And Eniku says, very cute card. So clever. Yay. It is cute. And it's something special. I wouldn't make one of these for everybody. And I think... I think that, you know, there are occasions where... See how tricky it is? It's tricky, but it's not difficult. Just tricky. But there are occasions where, you know, doing something special like this is warranted. And I think for my nephew, it's good. Okay, so thank you, Jerry Ann. I appreciate you letting me know when I'm out of camera and everything else. Where do you get the die? I'll tell you where I got my die. Because my craft store... Well, let me back up a second. We used to only have a Joann's, and it was one of them teeny tiny, minuscule, I called it a mini Joann's store. They don't even have half the stuff that's in the ad that you get every so often. It's really kind of difficult, actually, to buy craft supplies in this town. And now that we have Midtown Crafts, she specializes in things that Joann's doesn't have. So she doesn't have a lot of things like this. And she's a great place where you can go craft at her store, too. She's got a place where there's crafting tables and all kinds of things like that. So those two places were not an option for me to get this die. What I did was did a search, and I believe I put it in the description of... on my Facebook page and on my Google Plus page, I believe I put it in the description of this video, the actual names of the dies. There's two of them. And I just did a search on Amazon. And we're Amazon Prime members, so that meant free shipping if it was available, and it happened to be available. So I got them shipped to me from Amazon. And I hate that that is the better way to shop anymore, because I really prefer to shop in person. I prefer to put my hands on stuff. I prefer to give business to actual people, not to some entity out there. But this is the life we live in. And when you need something specific, you kind of have to go with however it'll work. And that was how it worked. And unfortunately, it was a really good shopping experience, which means I really like the idea. So I will probably be doing it again, which is sad. But anyway, yeah, so Karen Berniston, I'll look that up again. I don't know if it's Bernston or Berniston. B-U-R-N, I know for sure. She's also got a website where she shows how to put this together in picture format. So if you're a person who likes picture tutorials, I know Eniku is awesome at those. You can find that her tutorial on how to put this together as well. But do search. You'll find it. Okay, so that would be the base completed. Now it's time to just decorate and have some fun. And then it folds all up and goes into an envelope. And it's done for them. So there you go. Kind of cool how it works out, because this is the same, even though when you see it, it's not. Isn't that different? So this would be the front. So I'm just going to decorate them one panel at a time. And depending on which one I use, I don't know if I want to use this one. Yeah, I think we might do it that way. So then to decorate, I'm just going to have some fun with these things. So I understand if you have to go, we're 9 minutes over. That's not too bad. I thought before I looked up at the clock, I thought for sure it was going to be much later than that. I think I'm going to use the pearly one. And I'm just using some Tombow to adhere it. It's not drastic. I could use... the mono glue, but that's not, I'm in a hurry now that I know what time it is. Oh, and I wanted some bling. Hold on. Let's use these. These are left over from a workshop on the go. See what I mean? You get so many extras with your workshop on the go that you can do way more than just the little bit that they tell you you can do. And a couple of washi tapes, which actually this is not washi tape, this is glitter tape, but I have it in my washi tape drawer. And where did the roses go? And I have this little bag that I keep, I've collected these over the years, and it's got like ribbon roses and some paper flowers. And I'm always trying to figure out a way to use these, so we'll see if I can do this time. So, okay. So I've got those attached. I think I'll just put a piece of this. I like this heart washi tape. I think I'll put that on here. No, I won't. I'm going to put it on this side because I want it to show up on the white. There we go. And I'm just going to use one of these little ones. These are like glitter gems, and I think they came with the Christmas one last year. I don't know. So use that there. Just like that little bit of sparkly. Now shimmer trim. I do love my shimmer trim. Almost too much sometimes, but that's okay. I feel like you can never go overboard, and then sometimes I do anyway. So obviously you can. Just whether I do or not is a question. I don't know. Again, the nail issue. Okay, here we go. This is easier to work on if you fold it up like this, if you're doing the front panel anyway. And I cut it too long, so let's go to this right there. We go. Just give it a little sparkle. And I think I'll use the silver one as well. We'll just do the same direction for that one. All right, so that would be the front of it. And then I'm just going to decorate it with the rest of these a little bit here and there. So that way when it stands up, let's see, when it stands up, this is what you'll see. And if you decorate both sides, they'll see it from both sides. And this could actually just sit on their table for who knows how long. So I'm not going to complete the entire thing. I'll take a picture and post it on my Facebook and my Google page when I'm done. And yeah, that's it. So I think, you know what, you guys, I have had an awesome time. I'm so very grateful. Let me just make a change of camera scene here, just before I say goodbye. Let's see. It doesn't always work out best when I do these kind of things, but oh well. All right, so there we go. Oh, move that camera just a touch. All right, so I am so very thankful to all of you for joining me today. I feel like this is, some kind of new territory, even though it's the same thing we've been doing all along. I just feel so excited because there's all these new tools that I've been using, and I know I understand a little bit of how things work, so that's kind of cool. I'll say cool one more time. And hopefully I'll have this done within the next about 30 minutes probably, just with, you know, how it is when you craft. And I'll get a picture up, and hopefully you'll have enjoyed the time together. And I was just checking to see if there are any more comments. I hope you had fun. I had a blast. I really have enjoyed this. Looking forward to next Tuesday. We'll be on Tuesday. next week, and don't forget to add me to your circles, especially the page, because the page is like a little baby now. It's almost like we started all over or something. I don't know. Anyway, I hope you have a super fabulous, wonderful, crafty day, and we'll see you next week. And don't forget, all comments are entered into our giveaway. So thanks, and have a fabulously crafty day. Bye-bye.